My colleague Tanvi Shukla standing by in Varanasi. She's been getting us a sense of what's happening on ground, perspective. Tanvi, the Prime Minister addressing party cadre once again, obviously launching attack into the opposition as well. But at the same time, we're seeing Amit Shah meeting NDA leaders in an attempted show of strength. So yet another big day in Varanasi. Take us through what's happening on ground, the sense that you're getting currently.
Well, like you said, the Prime Minister started his day by addressing the party workers who obviously put up a great show and worked very hard to pull off that roadshow that they had, that they carried out yesterday. And as he leaves for other parts of the country today for campaigning, he's going to be leaving the charge of, on-ground campaigning here in Varanasi in the hands of these party workers, so essential to address them as well. Meanwhile, there has been a breakfast meeting with all the leaders of the allied parties. So you had Nitish Kumar, Uddhav Thackeray, Kasing Badal, Paswan, even the representatives of the NEDA who were present at this breakfast meeting. We were given to understand that all of them will also be accompanying Prime Minister Narendra Modi when he comes here where I am right now to file his nomination. So I'm right now at the collectorate's office. There's a lot of media presence here and a lot of security. And around 11:30, Prime Minister will come here to file his nomination papers. The last date for filing nomination is Monday. Elections, of course, in this constituency will only be held in the last phase, that's phase 7 on 19th of May. So once that is done by around 12:30, Prime Minister is expected to then leave and go to Maharashtra, and which is where he will be carrying out his next set of rallies, especially Sanjana in Mumbai. But it has been a week of messaging, lots of symbolism, show of strength from the road show to now, all the allies and the leaders coming in for just the nomination filing process for Prime Minister Modi is a signal to be sent to the party workers, to the supporters and to the citizens that this is a strong alliance. They have all these big names backing Narendra Modi. They have the people of Varanasi backing Narendra Modi, and he's going to be all set to fight this election from Varanasi.
Right, Tanvi, and what is the sense that you're getting on ground from the voter? Because let's remember, this also coming just a day after the Congress put all speculation to rest. They released a list of candidates, obviously none of them really, mentioning Priyanka Gandhi. So there may be a fair amount of political common sense obviously coming behind that. But what is the sense that you're getting on ground from the people of Varanasi?
Exactly that, Sanjana. Like you said, a little bit of political common sense to know that there is actually perhaps no point in setting up Priyanka Gandhi here in Varanasi to fight elections against Narendra Modi, because it's literally a no contest in this constituency. If she had, perhaps the contest would have been slightly more exciting. But the people that I spoke to yesterday, and in that whole 6-8 hours that we were on the streets speaking to people, it was very difficult to actually make out if somebody was just a citizen or a Modi supporter or a party worker, because almost everybody was excited at the same level and showing the similar kind of love and support for Narendra Modi. And they said that if Priyanka Gandhi had even come here to fight election, she would have lost so badly that she would have to give up her deposit money as well. So irrespective of how much of work has or has not been done in this constituency, Varanasi sees Narendra Modi as a great PM, PM that the country has, and a great candidate that they will get the chance to back. And so they're seeing the larger picture here. They're not really just judging him on the basis of an MP of a constituency.
Right, Tanvi, thank you so much for putting that in perspective and bringing us all the updates from Varanasi. Let's remember, that's where the Prime Minister will be filing his nomination shortly. Varanasi will also be going to elections in the last phase of the crucial and extremely significant Lok Sabha elections on May the 19th. Thank you so much, Tanvi, for that.